Hi, I'm Marcus Stolz, elloinos, and today I want to make a little announcement on my video. I set myself a challenge to show you Greek wines and Greek grape varieties, and I thought it might be a good idea to taste a total of 100 different Greek wines from each from a different grape variety. There's a lot of abundance of grape varieties in Greece, and I just want to bring these wines to your glass. And actually today I'm in vacation. I'm in Greece, at Peloponnese. This is the Peloponnese. I'm on the southern tip. It's an area called Laconia. And Laconia encompasses Sparta and Monbassia. If you've ever seen the movie 300, where the King Leonidas with his other 299 fighters held off the Persian army for 3 days, this is where it was done. The area of Laconia is best known for organic farming. A lot of products are available here, for example olives, also the vines, and it's very well known for oranges as well. Lots of nuts are grown here, wild sheep and goats roam around. There are great products like yogurt and other milk products. Also, there are wild pigs where the local speciality is sausage, and it's a very interesting area. And today's grape variety is called Kydonitsa. Now, Kydonitsa is one of the really distinguished white grape varieties of Greece, and I guess very few people have ever heard of it or even tried it. Now, Laconia has a very old history with wine growing. In ancient times, it has been growing wines for literally longer than thousands of years. Until the mid-1400s, 1460, Greece was invaded by Turkey, and under the Ottoman rule, wine growing was totally forbidden, and all the wines distinguished in this area. The occupation lasted until 1828. By that time, all wines had died out, there was nothing left, and no one knew how to grow wines. In the last years, or in the last 10 or 20 years, some ancient vineyards were discovered with the Kydonitsa grapes in them. And the local viticulturists took those grapes and nurtured them back to life. And the results of this grape variety just really start showing up right now. Let me tell you a little bit about the grapes. The grapes are grown in long elevated bunches. They ripen mid-September, and the color when the grapes are ripe is like a golden yellow color. And the must is fermented fairly cool at around 15 degrees Celsius to keep the bouquet alive. And let's just taste this. Now, all these videos are not about the grower. The grower here is Batistas, which is a grower from Monbassia. But it's rather about the grape variety itself. So let's open this up. See if I can work it with one of those. I really prefer the waiter is your friend. But this should work. Okay. Pour it in the glass. Take a look at the color. Like a very nice, it's a bit of a pale golden yellowish color, and actually it has some a little bit of green tinges on. Well, the nose is very fresh. It has quince on its nose, which is quite rare. Quince and pears, kind of lemon zest. It's a very fresh nose. Let's give it a go. It's actually quite medium to full body in the mouth. Lots of fruit, again, the quince and the pear is coming out very nicely. Also has good length, it just goes down and keeps on going. It just doesn't stop in the mid-palate. It's a very nice wine. Also good acidity, and it's really surprising. It's such a hot part of the country here, yet The acidity is there, it's fresh, and it's very nice body, very good body, actually. I like it. I could drink it every day. Certainly goes very well with food, like fish or vegetable dishes cooked in oil. Yeah, I really like this one. Well, thank you very much for joining me in this video, and I really would like to get your feedback on this. I mean, do you like this kind of video? You hate it? Tell me about it. Use the comment form below and just tell me what you think. And also, you guys can really help to bring the Greek wines into your local wine shops. Just go to your wine shop, go to your favorite wine merchant and ask them to show you the list of Greek wines. If they don't store any wines, give them my website, get in touch with me, because you can make it happen. It's up to you. Thank you very much. This is Mark Stolz from elloinos.